this program is that Hilltop Christian School exists not just for academics, not just for all the other stuff that we train our children to be what they want to be when they grow up, but Hilltop exists with this academics plus some. And that are those are the things that we do outside the Bible subject. And so interspersed in the program, in the songs, are little snippets of what we do to enhance the spiritual lives of our children. And we'll start with the flute quartet, Holy, Holy, Holy.
Thank you. get to share with you about chapel time at our school. Chapel time is on Friday mornings currently, and it's been my joy for the last 6 years. Well, pastor of the Antioch Seventh-day Adventist Church, to go on Fridays to our school and share the love of Jesus with our kids. It gives me a wonderful opportunity to get out my guitar and always sing with the children. This year has been a traumatic year for me. In October, I sliced off a portion of the end of my finger. It's hard to play guitar after you've sliced off a portion of your finger, but praise God, it's healed enough now where I can still play, and I praise God for that, because playing the guitar is one of my joys in life. And it's one way that I get to interact with our school kids. Because there are so many wonderful songs about Jesus that have motions and actions and that our children love to sing. So every other week finds me at the school, and every other week the school conducts a chapel service using student leadership from all of the different grades to conduct chapel. But on my week we lead songs and get to share with the two groups, the older children, third through eighth, and then the preschool comes in for their chapel service as well. And it is amazing to see the energy of our children as they love Jesus. Particularly our lower grades, some of them don't come from homes where Jesus is prayed to or where prayer is often conducted. And so it's a learning process for our young children to learn to pray. And so we get to share that with them week after week in our school. Our schools do not just exist to teach reading and writing and arithmetic. They exist to share Jesus in another R, a relationship. And to share that Jesus is their friend. And the Bible is an exciting book filled with some of the greatest stories of God's leading and power throughout all of Christian and Judeo-Christian history. So chapel time is a very special time, and I think just about every one of the Seventh-day Adventist schools worldwide has a chapel of some kind, either daily or in our case weekly. But at our school we also have daily worship, which you'll also hear more about as our program goes along. Our kids and your kids to us as we teach them to have a relationship with God.
Before I start talking about Vespers, I have to say, my one dream when I came to Hilltop Christian was for us to have a band. Thank you, David. I told my students they had to have notes if they were going to get up here and speak, so I have to have notes too. The second year I was here, I wanted to see what we could do to up the spirituality, not only the students, but also the families. And I decided what we needed to do was a once-a-month Vespers, Friday night, 7 o'clock, second Friday night of the month. It started with each one being school-run. All the teachers participated, not so much the students. But as we became more secure and more sure of ourselves, it became class-run. I love hearing the voice going out. Now each class takes charge of two of the Vespers each year, except for kindergarten. I think kindergarten only has one. The students lead the song service. The students have the scripture. The students have the prayer. You haven't lived until you have sat through a prayer led by a kindergartner or a first grader. They share what they're learning in their classes, and they give special music. We frequently have a small nature video connected with whatever the theme is that month. And we usually include a game that everybody at the Vespers can join in on. We end with a very special closing song where everybody stands up and makes a big circle around the sanctuary holding hands. Oh, did I forget about they get to have a drawing where they get from our treasure? Yeah, we don't want to forget that. And then we have a closing prayer. And everyone leaves feeling blessed by what they have seen these children do in leading the service. I know that I always leave feeling greatly blessed to have been a part of our Vespers program.
Thank you. Every year we try to do something that helps the young people in our school realize that there's more to life than just themselves. And so we like to reach out. Last year we collected money to buy Bibles for eBay. That was a huge success. We helped a lot of children with Bibles. And every year we do what's called Pennies for Patients. It's for the Leukemia Society. And we try to raise as much money as we can to help the children that have leukemia. And we do several things to encourage the children. The smaller ones like to take these little boxes home. They fill them with pennies, quarters, nickels, dimes. It's a lot of counting for me. Dollar bills, it's easier to count. And when they bring a dollar or more, they get a special paper penny that they put on the door of their classroom. And the little ones especially like to see their names up there and the money that they brought in. We also have a contest between upstairs and downstairs, just to give them a little incentive to do well. And there's a chart that goes up, and it's like a thermometer, and we see how far we can get. Well, this year, this is the upstairs, and we set a goal. Usually, it's been around $600. This year, we made it $650, trying to push them a little bit. And so the upstairs, especially the kindergartners, worked very hard. They went over their goal of $350. Downstairs reached their goal as well. And this year, the highest we've ever gotten, a total of $748.39. And so we're very happy that we can help these children, and we hope that our students will feel like they've done something to help children in need.
Thank you.
program is called Thoughtful Cards. This is a project that the third and fourth graders did, and what they were doing recently is sending out Get Well Soon cards to the shut-ins, especially to the members of this church. So from what I know about that is that they've been mailing these cards, and I'm not Annabelle. She's supposed to say more about that, but anyway, that's what our third and fourth graders have been doing to reach out for the community.
Before the band plays their number, I just wanted to talk a little bit more about the band. And I just want to let you know that this is the complete band. This is the elementary and those that have been playing for a while, all playing together. And one of the disadvantages of having a small school is that once you start playing, by the time you get to a point where you play pretty well, you graduate and you've gone on. So we have to do something about that and make our school a 12th grade school very soon. Don't you agree? So I just wanted to thank these kids for their hard work. We did a lot of work this year in playing at different functions. We played at the band festival, and I must say they did you proud. They did a great job. I'll pick one of our 8th graders, Nolawi. He is one of the main performers in one of our more difficult songs in the entire band. He did a brilliant job on that. And our 5th graders shone very well, and our 7th graders. We even had some 6th graders there, and they caught up with, and they kept up with all the other upper grades. So they are just a wonderful group of kids. As a teacher that works in a public school, I am absolutely thrilled to turn away from my morning duties and come to a school where we can worship the Lord, where there's an atmosphere where we can just talk about the Lord. And these kids, I'm telling you, they have caught on because they're willing to use whatever talents they have to praise the Lord. And I just love it. So I just want to thank the band for all their hard work this year, especially our 8th graders that are leaving. We may be in a little bit of a rebuilding year, but I may just have to not pass them maybe so you can come back and play with us some more. But thank you so much, parents, for all your work and all your support of the band this year. And there's one important thing that I forgot to do. You know, I am not one. I was going to announce this for the church service. I am just not one to segue the service into what benefits, what means a lot to me. When I look at a church service, I look at it as one that is praising the Lord, and it should stay there. So I didn't announce this before, but I want to announce it now to you. Thanks to your generosity, my flute was stolen a while back, and this is the flute that you guys helped me get. And thank you so much for inviting me here. Again, your support of the band and your support for their directors is just unique, and we really appreciate it.
Thank you. I'll be talking about the week of prayer that Mr. Karasoma did. I enjoyed week of prayer very much because I learned a lot. Mr. Karasoma taught the other students and myself that God loves us unconditionally and that we should just be ourselves. Each day of the week, we had a different lesson. My favorite one was forgiveness, because even though it was very hard to do, as long as we ask, Jesus always finds it in his heart to forgive us. He also taught us a wonderful song called Cast Your Burdens. Cast your burdens on Jesus, for he cares for you. Cast your burdens on Jesus, for he cares for you. Higher, 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 higher. Lift Jesus higher, higher, a higher, higher. Higher, 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 higher. Lift Jesus higher. A lower, 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 lower. Some Satan lower, lower, a lower, 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 lower. Some Satan lower. A wider, 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 wider. God's love is wider, wider, a wider, 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 wider. God's love is wider.
The second week of prayer that we did at school this year was charged by the eighth grade, and our theme was to love one another and to work together. One of the things that we did was make human machines, which is us acting like machines and working together to get the job done. One of the things that we learned while we were doing it was that working together is better than one working alone.
In the bulletin, it says that we'll be playing Be Thou My Vision, but we'll be playing 10,000 Reasons.
So, Yulia, what have you been studying about this year?
Fruits of the Spirit.
Where can you find all list of these fruits of the Spirit?
Galatians 5:22-23.
Of all the fruits of the Spirit that we learned about, which do you think is the most important?
Love.
That was a quick answer. Tell me something. Who were some of the leaders and historical figures we learned about?
Jesus, Esther, Robert Mueller, and Joseph.
And tell me something. How are we in our classroom using the fruits of the Spirit to share with others?
Writing children's book. We can share them with our study buddies also.
Yes, our class got a whole box of Bear books, B-A-R-E. And we are currently writing children's books to share what we've learned about the fruits of the Spirit.
First and second grade class, about a month ago, finished a book that was called Alexander and the Terrible, Horrible, No Good, Very Bad Day. And it's about a little boy who just has an awful day from start to finish. And we were talking about how we could make our days better. And one of the things we decided was, of course, we need to start our days with Jesus, right? And take all of our problems to him. And so we were going to talk a little bit about our worship. And every morning, just like in all the other classes, we have a worship. And we love to sing in our class. And we sing lots and lots of songs. And I brought my friend Corinne up here in second grade. And she is going to share a couple songs that are her favorites.
Jesus loved me, this I know. Number 43.
Okay. I was just asking her if she liked 43, because I know she asks for that all the time at school, which is also known as He's Everything to Me.
Well, Corinne, what stories do we read? We also read a Bible story every morning. What Bible stories have we been reading lately?
Joseph, Esther, and Noah.
Yep, those are some of the stories that we've been reading about in the morning. And how do we end worship every morning?
Praying.
We all pray, don't we? A lot of first and second graders are still a little unsure about how to pray. And that's one of the things that we learn in there. If they don't already know how, we all take turns praying. And is that the only time we pray during the day, Corinne?
No.
When else do we pray?
During lunch and when we go home.
Yep. So those are our scheduled times. And, of course, we can talk to Jesus anytime, right? Thank you, Corinne.
I'd like to say something about this group. This is supposed to be the eighth grade group. However, one of them is absent, who has been sick for about 3 weeks already, Kenji. So I have a seventh grader take his place, Limpty. And then one of them was here this morning, and now I don't find him anywhere. So we make do of what we have, and praise God for what we have.
You know, in performance, when you make a mistake, you just smile. So that's what they did. They just laughed.
Sit down. I put this category here as blessings. This is actually a little tribute for Dr. Kirby. You know, she has been here for how many years? 5 years. And everybody brings a blessing, and so I just call it a blessing. If you look at the back of the bulletin, I was able to look for sayings about blessings, and I'd like you all to participate. Dr. Kirby, could you stand up, please? So, let's do it. Do you have a bulletin? Everybody has a bulletin? No? Okay. Let's read the first box there together. Give thanks for unknown blessings already on their way. The next one. May the sun bring you now energy by day. May the moon softly restore you by night. May the rain away your worries. May the breeze blow new strength into your being. And here's your favorite. May the road rise up to meet you. May the wind always be at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face and rains fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of his hand. And the last box here. May your days be merry and your troubles be few. May all God's blessings descend upon you. May peace be within you. May your heart be strong. May you find what you're seeking wherever you roam. I was able to gather a surprise for you, and that is the student that graduated while you were here. Come up. And they're going to play handbells. We had one rehearsal Wednesday evening and then about 30 minutes ago, so. But they were handbellers before, so they still know how to do it. Did pretty good. They did very good. So thank you so much, alumni. And maybe I should interview these guys for a little bit. Yassi, what are you doing now? They're all, they're all
All of you are still in high school, right? Okay, good. That's great. So we should praise God for these are products of Hilltop. And they are on the way to higher learning, and we're very, very proud of you. So I hope that you will always remember Hilltop, and you will always remember me and all the other things that I do. Okay. I would like to just, at this point, acknowledge our pianist. His name is Isaiah Heimer. He's a student of Pleasant Hill Adventist Academy. I just gave him the music last week, went to his house. Here's the music that you're going to play for us, and I'm glad that he obliged. His parents are not with him today because the sibling is doing an adventurer's investiture or something. So I have to pull him out from the family today, and I'm just so glad that Isaiah is here with us today. He was my piano student for a while, and now he has moved on to some bigger things. Okay, Dr. Kirby, this is a song that we'd like to sing for you again because I know that you liked this a lot. We sang this last year, so choir, please come up. We'll have two last songs. God is So Good, and then a new song from the Girls Ensemble. Ella, if you remember the song, you can come up. I mean, Tessa. You were still there last year. This is going to be our benediction song, and thank you so much for being here with us today. We really appreciate your support, and I see the presence of the new principal, Mr. Mickey. Thank you for being with us here today also. So the Lord bless you and keep you, and we always pray that, of course, the Lord bless and keep our church and our school and our students, our teachers, and thank you very much for being with us this afternoon.